Five on your help now. Plenty of us think we're not getting good sleep, right? Or enough of it, that's for sure. And sometimes there's something more serious to blame for that. And now your watch may be able to tell you about it. So here with us is Dr. Todd Ellerin of South Shore Health to talk more about this. These watches are getting more and more sophisticated, especially when it comes to our health, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
Let's talk about it here because I know there's a new feature on the Apple Watches where it detects sleep apnea. So is this more bad sleep? It's more than bad sleep, right?
Right, so basically what's happened is this Apple Watch can detect movement in the wrist. And they did a study that compared it to sleep studies at home. And they showed that it often detected patients with sleep apnea about 66% of the time. It could detect severe sleep apnea 89% of the time, but for moderate sleep apnea was more of a coin toss, about 43% of the time. But one thing I want to make the point, this is good for screening, but it's not diagnostic. You still have to get that sleep study. That's important.
It's a good first step, right? So, because we know millions of people may have sleep apnea, right? Some degree of it anyway. So why is it so important to get diagnosed?
Right, we think about 39 million people in the United States have sleep apnea. The reason it's so important to be diagnosed is because it's associated with cardiovascular disease like heart attacks and strokes. Believe it or not, it can be associated with things like dementia as well, also high blood pressure. And this daytime sleepiness, it can cause problems, obviously, in our personal lives, at work. The other thing is you have increased motor vehicle accidents because of it. So it's really important to make this diagnosis.
Absolutely. Okay, so your watch tells you you have it, right? Something to be mindful of. We talked about what's next, getting the testing right, but you know, talk about how important that is and what people should be keep in mind when they are going to go get tested, because I think some folks are wondering, you know, what does that entail? Is it worth doing?
Right, and it really is because of the reasons we just said. Again, this is excellent to think about screening. And the one thing it didn't show was people with normal breathing, it didn't go off and detect any sleep apnea. Mm. So it was pretty specific. It did miss, again, it was only 66% sensitive. That means 33% of people with sleep apnea, it missed,
right.
Okay? But it is a step in the right direction. Another thing to go out and get help. Remember, if you have daytime sleepiness, despite a good number of hours of sleep, if you are snoring or someone tells you you're snoring,
yeah,
try to get help before your partner leaves the bedroom. And of course,
yes,
if your partner says you've stopped breathing, these are other reasons to do it. This is just another early signal that can help us.
Another sign. Thank you so much, Dr. Ellerin, as always for your insight.
Take care, Jessica.